Hello and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 22 on Bally Springs. Right, I have changed it over to July, guys, because we had nothing else to do over in June, and obviously it means it is now harvest season on the farm. So yeah, we basically just want to get this up and running. I just want to make sure we've got everything we need on the farm. Let's unfold that. I do believe we got straw swath enabled, so we should be good to get some straw as well from these fields. But yeah, it's harvest season, guys, so we need to get started. There we go, beautiful straw. Yeah, we're not really going to need much straw this year, I don't think. We've still got a little bit left from last year, which is really good, because at the end of the day, I think we should have more straw this year than we did last year. I genuinely think we will. Just because I think we're doing two slightly bigger fields than we did last year. Because last year we did two canola, was it? Just gonna leave that there before, yeah, get that straw stop dropping. And now we'll make our way down and round. There we go, beautiful. But yeah, if we can get a headland done on this, I'm hoping we might be able to get a bit of a worker going on this field. But let me get rid of that menu. Let's just have a look here. Look at that. Lovely view. I do apologize for the stuttering, guys. It's another new vehicle. It's just having that little stutter issue since the since the update the other day. I know a lot of people have had some issues with the update as well, guys. I don't know if anyone else is having updates, any issues with the update, shall I say. I haven't personally come across any that I can say, well, that worked before the update. But I know some people are having some issues. Apparently you got modified like a line of code or something. I saw it over on the Giants forum. What a nightmare is that corner, isn't it? Absolute nightmare. But as you can see, we are making our way around this headland. Obviously, off recording, I will probably just windrow the straw up a little bit, you know, just so it's bigger piles, just so it doesn't take as long to do. But this year, guys, we are going to have to deal with the weeds. Our environmental score is getting affected by us not dealing with them. We're not growing weeds to deal with them. We're always plowing. If you plow on the game every time, it does actually affect your environmental score. That's why our weeds never seem to, you know, that's why our environmental payout never seems to really go up. I am hoping as well that we don't need to put much grain. And we don't need to put much grain into the silo this year as well. I do believe we can sell quite a bit of it, because at the end of the day, we still got grain from last year. And if we don't need to store it for the chickens, now, when I say that, our chickens are always breeding. And yeah, I'm not really sure if we're gonna ever use as much as we make, but we do still have grain from last year. And I don't want to keep excess grain and, you know, not be making money from it, basically. Normally this field is enough for the grain. Normally this field is enough. Now I'm hoping that if we can get this second headland done, back now there, get a second headland done, I might be able to get a bit of a worker on this. Now I could technically put a worker on this field anyway and get the get cosplays up, but it's harvest season. I haven't really got much else to other than harvest, but we do have trailers that we're gonna have to go and empty, things like that. So maybe at some point we'll get a worker going, maybe while we do the running around. But as you can see, we're 56% full already. I'm gonna get the radio turned on, guys, just at the end of the day. I'd like to try and get more than one field done if I can. I know this is the biggest field. This always takes the longest to do, but we have got four fields to harvest this year, so it would be nice to get two done today for the next episode. And then that way we can keep the series moving along nicely. Like I say, we've got a draw to do as well. But I'm hoping maybe with a little bit of money we've got left in the bank, we're gonna get our hands on one of the John Deere's square balers, one of the cheapy ones, just to try and make it a bit easier to move bales around the map, something like that. Yeah, I'm gonna get the radio turned on, guys, when I get to this corner, and then we'll get as much done as we can in the time lapse while we listen to the radio. Oh, we missed a bit. Would you believe it? I'm about to start my time lapse and I miss a little bit. Would you believe it? That is such a reaper thing to do. There we go. Right. I'll see you once we've got as much done as we can, guys. As you can see, we've managed to get another harvester load on this field. Oh, the Lamborghini, guys, is so nice to drive. It's so quiet to drive. It's got power. Well, it's got power that I need at the moment. We'll find out when it comes to the bit. I've just done that completely wrong. Right, I'm gonna do this a little bit of a different way. I think I'm just gonna drive around. I don't have to worry about driving like on less of a hill, do you know what I mean? I completely forget how much power this thing's got, and the speed it's got is unreal. Oh, it's so nice to just dip around and go anywhere I want. It's so nice. Yeah, guys, I'm glad everybody is enjoying the old school series as well. It really does mean a lot that everybody is really enjoying that series. Yeah, and I hope everyone is still enjoying the Bally Springs series. I am absolutely love playing these at the moment, and the old school series may likely come to an end when Court Farms comes out. I'm thinking of taking the old school series over to Court Farms just because it's I need to go and empty my trailer. But while I'm here, let me just have a look in my silo, because I need, yeah, look, Barley. I've still got 13,000 litres of barley. I kept the barley. So yeah, we can... Yeah, we're not using all the grain from the field for the chickens. So it's time to be selling some grain. Oh, whoa, I've crashed my new tractor. Oh my. I need to leave the forks at the bottom. I did mean to leave them at the bottom to begin with. And I accidentally left them on, hence why I'm still driving with them on. That was just more user error, as in I'm the user and I created the error. Yeah, when we come out of this silo, I will just I'll just dump the forks and load it on the floor. Just so got a little bit more maneuvering room. Alright guys, I'm constantly trying to listen for Milado, because Milado's off. Well, I think he's got flu, guys. I think he's got flu. But unfortunately, because of his breathing issues in general, flu can be quite nasty for him. Yeah, he ain't got like proper like bad medical problems with breathing, but he does suffer severely with his asthma, and because of that, obviously, the flu can be an absolute nightmare for him, bless him. But on the good news is he's like, well, I'm not going to school today. You know, he doesn't like school. But no, you know, yeah, all right. Overall, he doesn't like going to school, but he's got 2 days a week that he genuinely hates. And today's not one of them, actually. So he'll be gutted. Yeah, he's off school today with what I suspect to be flu. Most people are like, oh, COVID. It, you know, something, it could be, but I doubt it. Let's be fair, right? COVID doesn't really exist anymore, does it? What a shock. Here, let's just get the rest of this grain tank. Yeah, I can't believe the grain tank got full going this way. My own fault. I should have done a fourth headland. Because I am having a little bit of issue doing some turning around. I am most likely, though, guys, going to get the radio turned back on soon, because I would like to try and get another field done in this episode. But I also know that this is the biggest field we have to do on the farm, and I know this takes the longest to do. I know that there's not much we can do about that. It's just the way it is. The biggest field on the farm, it takes the longest, especially with this little header. Now we could try and get a bigger header, but the problem is I don't have the room to get the header in the field. Which is why we still use a small header. Now, we might look when we get chance and we've got loads of money and we're making loads of money to the point where we might actually buy a better harvester that holds more grain. Because it only holds like 6,500. Our trailer only holds 11,000. We do need to get a better trailer, but I think at the moment, the next thing we want to get our hands on is a square baler. That means hay and... straw bales will be bigger, so we'll have less of them to move. That's kind of where I'm going with that. And we can technically afford one now, but you know, we do have a loan we have to pay off again. Now I know we've got a loan and that kind of sucks at the moment, but we've got some income coming in. I've got a full crate of honey. I'm going to have a second crate of honey in August. We're going to have a full crate of eggs in August. We've got one tomato sauce and we've got one French fries at the moment. And I'm thinking of using all that production stuff to pay money off the loan. We don't really have to pay $5,000 off every couple of months like we did before. You know, the bank kind of trusts us now to just pay it off, because we've had big loans from them before and, you know, we've always paid it. Yeah, this has been a very annoying field to get done. I'm going to say that now. the shape of the field on its own is part of the reason why it's such a freaking nightmare to do. Banging my steering wheel in full lock and all this. I do it every time. I might have to start stealing the wife's steering wheel. Hers doesn't clatter as much, but I think it's more the desk that it's on that helps, you know, doesn't help with the noise. I say the wife's got a good desk, but she's got an IKEA desk and it's basically just cardboard and it's slowly falling apart. There, get another headland. This is what a better way of harvesting, rather than doing an exact 3-point turn. But before I had to do a 3-point turn because we were at the top, and I can't judge like equal distance. I can't do on this game. People can like do a headland and then go halfway down the field and get it perfect, and I'm like, how the hell did you do that? I'd end up with like this tiny little bit I'd have to do every time. Yeah, I should have done a fourth headland. It would have made turning a lot easier if I'd have done a fourth headland. But it's also good to know, because if we ever did cosplay on any of these, we'd have to do four headlands to make sure we had a good amount of turning circle. Otherwise, it would get stuck on all the hedges. Yeah, this field is pretty much coming to an end. I think we might be able to get another field done. Maybe one of the smaller ones. Well, it won't be a big one, that's for sure. Definitely won't be a big one. Blended. I think this is doing well. I think this has yielded really well as well. I think overall we've had two harvester loads. Can't remember what it was last time. I could go to the episode, find out how much grain we got off. But the thing is, I've done nothing different this time than I did last time. But I'm hoping next time, like I say, rather than plough it, we're going to cultivate, but it does mean we're going to have to deal with the weeds. So we need money in the bank to buy a weeder. That's got to be done. If we spray, though, it won't work. We've got to do the weeder or a grown crop. We want to try and get this environmental score higher. Point turn again anyway, because we're finally getting to the last couple of strips. There we go. Yeah, that should just about give us almost three. Two and three quarter harvester loads, I reckon. Pretty much. By the time we get to the end. Oh, sorry about that. Not my microphone. Oh, wrong way, Reaper. Come on, learn to drive in reverse. You reckon yourself look like a farming noob right now. Gonna drop that straw there in the same place. Or I go reversing and making a big mess. But yeah, what, 71% when we started this? It's gonna be more than three quarters of a harvest load, so that is really, really good. That is really, really good. Get that out ready, we'll drive up to the Lambo. We do need to get a better trailer though. That's the capacity of that trailer is a bit unrealistic for that size, so we do need to get our hand on another trailer. But it's just I'd rather spend the money on other things than having to replace that trailer. 78%. That is not bad going at all. I'm hoping we can sell the majority of the straw as well. I don't think we're going to need to keep much. Well, that's doing on there. Yeah, look, we've got 11,700 litres in there. Just want to double check something on. Yeah, they don't take straw. I think there's only the dairy cows take straw. Yeah, it is. It's just the dairy cows. Oh, I've just smashed the Lambo. Right, I'm probably going to have to use a little bit of strength around this corner, guys. I need to remember to go into... I've been in giant editors so much lately, and I've not once remembered to make this... All I want to do is I just want to make this gap a fraction bigger so that I can drive in here without crashing, basically. All it is... See what I mean? Just, I've been meaning to do it now for about what? A week? 2 weeks? When was the last time we harvested? But either way, yeah, that's when we was meant to do it. And I just, oh man, I've been helping other people on Giant Editor trying to figure things out. And like, oh yeah, you do this, you do this, you do this, you know, tutorials like that. I said, I don't know loads about it, but I know little bits. There's a little bit of information I know, I'm more than happy to share it. Just like I probably found it elsewhere or worked it out in the hardware myself. Ooh, is that going to fit down there? Yes. Tight squeak, right. If I remember rightly, this is an extremely tight field. When we get, you see that post there sticking out? We get to that post, it's very, very tight there. Ooh, perfect. Look at that. Lovely. Right, this is soybean, guys. This is the crop that we will be selling this year. This is the soybean crop. We will get some soybean straw from it, I think. We have got the straw. Yeah, like I say, and any straw we get, it's just another way of making a little bit of money by having all the straw and all the crop stuff. Missed that corner, didn't we? Yeah, I'm going to get the radio turned on this straight away, guys. I want to try and get this done in this episode, so I will see it once we complete this field. We got it done. We got it done. We came out with 4,000 litres of canola as well. I do believe that is pretty much what we got from the last lot of canola as well in the field. So those fields are not that different in size, you know, them bottom fields. But if we go and empty this wheat now into the next into the field, Into the silo, sorry, into the field. And then we'll go into the field to get the canola out. And then in the next episode, guys, we should have two smallish fields to harvest. Won't be loads, to be fair, just two smaller fields. I'd like to get bales. Don't think I want much chance. I might do that once I've strawed. Once I've done the straw bales as well. But I'm hoping that buying this new square baler. I'm not going to try and buy it though until I really need it. I'm surprised something hasn't come up in the shop yet. We've only ever had one baler in the shop. We ended up buying it. Now we'll never sell the round baler we've got because that's good for the silage. But get that in there. It's only 4,000 litres. But then this puts us ready for doing the. I think they're both barley fields, if I remember correctly. I do, like I say, guys, I've got an absolutely awful memory. Yeah, 4,000 litres of canola should do us quite well. So, what's the best price for canola ever? £706. So, yeah, it's about, what, 2,800 pounds plus the bonus. Obviously, we've got 13,000 litres of barley. Obviously, we're going to add to that. Which one sells for the most on here? Sorry. 398. Right, yeah, so it's the wheat that we... Yeah, I remember now. It's the wheat that we sell. What I'm going to do, I'm going to just quickly go and park this down by this gate so then we know where we are tomorrow. And then I was thinking of doing a little bit of windrowing just off the corner, you know, just to make the straw swaps a little bit neater. So, you know, I do it every time, every year. No one seems to have an issue with that. Just because, can you imagine going around this field as many times as we did with the harvester? And just go around it with the windrow. I basically get two swaps into one. It's not really the end of the world. Bloody tight around here. Jeez. Yeah, this is why we have this header and not the other one. That's why we make the Frankenstein harvester. I know I always call it the Frankenstein harvester. Ash, you know, but it's not the right header for this machine, but it works. It really does work, and I don't mind having it as a red header because at least like the logos on that and the text is in red. But it does kind of match a little bit. Yeah, it's just not wide enough to get the. I suppose in theory, we could put better gates in it. Got better gates in the field, so if you put gates in a new location, you wouldn't have a problem with that. But just for now, I'm going to park that one there, and we're going to go and put this little bit of... when does a canola sell? Curiosity. When does a canola sell? 7:06. November. Everything is November. I know that something sells. Oh, it's soybeans. Yeah, we're not planting soybeans. Although, what does... Soybeans? 1,100. It might be worth doing a soybean rather than a canola. The thing is, canola gives me canola straw, rapeseed straw, you know, which is actually a thing that farmers in the UK use. I know that because I've seen other people talking about it. And, you know, I did a bit of research. I'm like, oh, you actually get straw from that one. So, not many farmers. I will give it that. But we'll sell it. You know what I mean? We'll sell it. We're not bothered. We'll sell it for money. There we go. So if I can get that in there, 4,134 litres. It's a little bit of money come, you know, it's a few grand come the end of the year when it's time to sell. What we'll probably do in a minute, actually, is off recording, I might just go and top the chickens up, actually, with the barley. The barley, I don't think we're going to need to keep all the barley. I think we should come out with about 8,000 of barley. I've done it wrong again. I keep going under there for my silo to empty it, and it's not, it's in here. I keep doing that over and over again. yeah, that's more than enough just to top the chickens up. But yeah, guys, I hope you have enjoyed this episode. You know, it's harvest season. I don't really know what else we can do other than harvest. But we have got some wool I need to go and take up to the spinnery. We've got a couple of little items just to sell, but I'm just trying to get the harvest season out of the way. You know, it's one of the busiest times, because obviously once we finish harvesting, we need to get in, we need to cultivate, we need to get seeded. You know, we've got quite a bit we need to get done ready for the next year. So I believe this is going to be year four. We're preparing for now. Have year three over with. Yeah, like I say, I've got a really, really terrible memory. Terrible memory, it really is. Let's get that topped up. There you see, yeah, it only took 3,000. Top that up. I don't think we... Now, I know the more chickens we get, the more it would take. I know that, you know, you have to top it up. But as of right now, I don't think we're going to need to sell. We're going to have to keep all the barley. We're still going to have... But I'm going to check it in a minute. Yeah, as I say, guys, I hope everybody has enjoyed this episode. I really do. It has been a good one for me. It's harvest season. I know I've just said that. I'm just... Because I need to put this back in here, and what have we got? 5,000 litres. 8,000 litres. We've got now. You see, look, we've already got 10,000 litres, and we're gonna have another, I reckon, 8,000 litres coming off that field there. Actually, I reckon we'll get about 12,000 litres. So we might be able to get rid of sort of quite a bit of grain this year, which will help us bring in some money if we can afford to buy a new production. Start making some flour. That would be really, really handy. As I say, guys, thank you so much for watching this episode. I hope you have enjoyed it, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye for now.